Hello trainers and welcome back to Pokemon Masters. So I wanted to do a quick video about the egg event that we had this week because I managed to get myself a shiny cider. I know, a bit of a bragging thing to say, but just when I hatched it I thought to myself, why not make a video about the egg update, or rather the egg event. And so we will make one. And this video will be about the first part covering the egg event and what it means for the future of the game. The second part will be about the rewards of the egg event, and the third part will be about egg sync pairs in general, sorry, not egg trainers, because the trainer is always you. So let's start with the event. So the event is based around a type of Pokémon, in this case the bug type, and we have an all-around challenge going from normal to super hard that only awards eggs. So you know that eggs have various rarities, from the lowest rarity being copper, then silver, and then gold. So the copper one drops from normal, for example, with a really boosted rate of 28%, and then you have also a really small chance to get a silver one. The second one, the part 2, awards you a higher chance to get a silver one and a lower one to get a copper one, and of course the very hard is the same with higher silver, low gold, and the super hard only gives you a gold one. All these eggs are bug type, which means that you get the 4 new Pokémon that have been added to the eggs, which are Weedle, Venonat, Scyther and Pinsir, with Scyther and Pinsir of course being the 2 rarest ones. However, you also have some challenges in the quest that awards you with really interesting stuff. So I have completed some of them, but to give you an example, we have eggs with guaranteed Pokémon inside them. As you can see, we have an egg with Pinsir being guaranteed inside of it. Then we have tickets to upgrade your 1-star sync pairs, which are the egg sync pairs, so you can start upgrading your Pokémon that you acquired just now to the levels of the Gacha sync pairs or the free ones as well. Then we have the treats, which help you upgrade the stats of an egg Pokémon. And of course, last but not least, we have also the 3-star and 2-star power-ups. So this overall is a really generous free event, I should say, because it doesn't really give you a ton of gems for the gacha. However, it gives you a ton of free Pokémon, which is something that I really enjoy, because it is a layer of free gacha inside the gacha that it is really enjoyable. It is enjoyable to farm eggs, to put them here, and to wait to get maybe a shiny Pokémon. So, as you can see, I have already hatched a ton of eggs. I have got myself a really nice Weedle, I should say. And overall, we will check this out later, but I also think that some sync pairs can be really valid if you choose to upgrade them. So now, we will move about talking what this means for the future schedule of events. I feel like we will get each month a new egg-type event. This month is Bug, maybe next month will be Psychic, who knows. And this also adds some interesting scenarios to the game, because Pinsir is a Pokémon that is already available as a sync pair. You have Pinsir and Mega Pinsir. So this is really interesting, because it means that the trainer could potentially ally with every Pokémon that you already have. I want to know if you guys enjoy this, if you like the fact that you can get every Pokémon for free in the future, maybe. It is not a guarantee. And the fact that you can also get them as a shiny. The fact that they are shiny, I feel like, is really cool, because it adds sort of a collectionist side to this. I know many of you are worried about the paid gems, however, as you can see, they decided to give us for free a limited time slot for the duration of this event, which I feel like it is really generous on their part, because it means that we get 2 chances to get a new Pokémon. I should also advise that you may want to choose only one Pokémon to upgrade, because I feel like the rewards are limited to focus on that one Pokémon, and then after that you need to wait the next upgrade. So I will focus more on the sync pair side of the egg Pokémon later. However, I just wanted to say, so far we have 4 types of events. We have the story events, we have the solo events, we have the legendary Pokémon event, and now we have the egg events. And also the training events, but those are basically glorified events, they don't really add anything. I feel like with the upcoming Elite 4 mode, that could also be another layer of events. And overall I feel like the game really benefits from having this many events add a tweet. I want to hear your take on this as well, but I feel like the event is probably one of my favorite, even if the week kinda gets a little bit boring, I should say, because there isn't really much to do. But from the gameplay side of things, I really like the fact that they added a way to feel like the game is a sort of Pokémon, because you get a new Pokémon, you can train it, you can name it. The fact that you can name it, I really like. It can be shiny, it can be any Pokémon, you have the surprise of it being an egg and so on. So I really like that side of things. Let me know which Pokémon you hatch as well. I would really like to know if you managed to get a shiny Pinsir, a shiny Rattata, any of those kinds of Pokémon. In my journey as a Pokémon trainer, I got maybe 2 or 3 shinies without having events or so on, which I feel like is an average number, it's not really that bad. So now, the third part and last part of the video, I wanted to check together with you the sync Pokémon that comes together with the egg. We will check out my shiny Sider as an example of most of the Pokémon, because I haven't made any other sync pairs together with the egg Pokémon. I feel like this one is pretty standard. I call him Buzz because the sound of the bug makes sometimes is called buzzing in English, and I like the idea of Buzz Lightyear, the guy from the Disney movies, the fact that he wants to fly, and Sider can, I think he can't fly as well. I think that's something that Sider has in the games. So let's check out what this pair does. So you have 2 standard abilities, Slash and Bug Buzz. One is physical and one is special attack. Slash interacts with critical hits, while Bug Buzz interacts with lowering your target special defense. Then you have 3 predetermined trainer moves for the trainer, which are Raise You and other 2. This one is more offensive because it raises speed and user crit rate, which is really good for Sider, especially if you go for a Slash build. Then you have X Attack, which raises the user attack, which is also good for Sider. And for passives, you get 3 of them. I hope that this is because it is shiny, because then you are guaranteed to get a really good Pokémon if it is shiny, which makes it more likely that you use him. It has Haste, which cannot lower its speed. Critical Strike 3, which is amazing, because it power ups attack if they become critical hits, which with Slash you can see how good it is. And then you have Bug Shift, which changes normal type moves to bug type moves. In this case I think Slash was normal type. So overall you can see already a flow in this Pokémon, which is the stats. But don't worry, you have 3 ways to raise stats, sorry, 2 and 1 to raise trainer move. So to raise stats, of course you can level up, but you can also raise your Pokémon affection. How do you raise it? You get those treats from the events, you gave them to Sider for example, and you raise this affinity progress bar. Every time you raise it, your stats will raise as well. You can also change your name from here, which I suggest that you do because it is really a core part of the Pokémon core design. This has a limit of course of 2 out of 3, so you have 3 levels of affinity to raise for your Pokémon. And then of course you have the potential upgrade. We saw already that we have 1 star and 2 star tickets. After you complete every stage of the reward structure, you should get up your egg trainer up to star 3, which means that you should get an average sync per level 3 stat line, which is decent, I should say. Overall, you can see why I suggested that you guys focus on just 1 trainer per event. I will report back when I fully upgrade my shiny Sider. I probably will use it in bug content because I don't really have any decent bug Pokémon. Overall, I feel like this Sider is really solid. Probably the rarest Pokémon will have the better stats and passives. I have no idea on how passive works. I guess they have a pool of passive for each Pokémon that comes from an egg, and it tries to give them the best one if you are lucky. You can also evolve some Pokémon from the eggs. For example, you can evolve Bellsprout, Rehir, Weedle, Zubat, Meow, Nidoran, Rattata. And I suggest to upgrade the Pokémon that have 3 symbols right here. 3 symbols meant that he has 3 passives. For example, let's check out Bellsprout. Bellsprout has Wide Awake, Power Reserves 2, and Super Duper Effective 1, which I never saw, to be honest. You want to choose the one with the best combos for you. And also take a notice that they have different roles, even if they are the same Pokémon. So you can have a support Sider, an attack Sider, or a tech Sider. It is up to you to choose which one you want. I feel like Sider is best in attack for how it is built, but that's obviously a personal choice. Anyway, this was the coverage that I wanted to do for this event. I hope that you guys enjoyed this sort of smaller videos. I will resume the showcases for trainers very soon. Give me some time to think about how to make them more interesting to watch. Anyway, next week we also have an exciting update. I will try to cover what comes with it, even if it is the much-hated stamina system. I also want to see some hype for whatever the data mine can bring us, even if I can talk about it freely. We already know that we have a summer event and a Palkia event incoming, and I can also guess that we will have some info about the anniversary countdown. Thank you very much for joining me. As Dawn is waving away, we will see each other next time. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed the video, and remember to let me know which eggs Pokemon and what sync pairs you decided to make for your egg Pokemon. Hopefully a nice Strike Cider so you can join with me. I also hope that you guys get a shiny out from this event, and I also hope that you enjoy the game. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, remember to leave a like and a sub to support me. And if you want to see more of Pokémon Master, you won't have to wait for long, because next week will be hype as hell. This is Hunter Lodge, and I hope that you have enjoyed your stay with the Egg Bug Type event. Bye, guys!